Hey everybody, I'm Andrew Hochrottle.
And I'm Nick Longo.
We host a show called Anchor Points at 1 p.m. Pacific every Wednesday at twitch.tv/Adobe.
And if you missed the episode, here's a highlight.
What is the new trend that we're seeing for 2023?
It's the weird, wild world of wild fonts. I don't know how else to describe this new trend. I've called it melty fonts. I've called it overly decorative. I like the abstract vibe of it. I think it's breaking down typical architectures of what a letter form is. I love anything new in that way. And I just want to make sure we talk a little bit about maybe usage of these, because as much as I do like them in certain ways, I think there's certain applications where maybe they could be a little risky. I don't know. What do you first like to call it as a category?
So in theory, if we're looking at a historical perspective, which will be a segment that we do a little bit later, is from a historical perspective, I do think that this would fall under a category called Tuscan lettering. It's something to where they kept adding and adding and adding to type. We had sans serif, we had serif, we had slab serif, and then we got into a zone called Tuscan, and it was throwing everything you possibly could onto type to make it look crazy. And I think that we're coming back to it. I love this, and I hope it sticks around forever. My thought on type is always that I want it to be readable, but not necessarily legible. That's a quote from David Carson. So I'm fully okay with this. And if we look at the trends that we saw, we literally did a Google search for type trends 2023. Here's what it is.
It sums it all up beautifully. Wow. Okay, so here's some characteristics I see. I see a lot of thick and thin.
Yes.
In areas that we typically did not see that are typical structures of fonts, correct?
Yeah.
That's what I love.
I do too. I think that it's innovating, and this is why I like this style, and I hope it sticks around as a trend for a little while, is it's new. Again, our theme is new. It feels new. It feels fresh, but it's kind of hearkening back to the basics, right? That it's about good letter structure, but it's about exploring what you can do and what could be new with type. And even the weird kind of like blobby stuff. But then I also love this very scripty kind of addition kind of stuff that you see even in your example here.
Yeah.
There's a lot of kind of embellishments. I think it's interesting and new. Would this be something that you would explore, Nick, in your workflow?
I kind of have, and I've changed my whole Word logo for my company inspired by this in a lot of ways, because I like this uniqueness of the negative space can now be very unique and different. So, and the thick and thins can be there when it comes to doing something new. And it's very inspirational to see people play with fonts more than ever before. I think when I first saw this, I immediately said no to it because I'm all about legibility and branding, but we can't help but be influenced by this. I think what's gonna happen is we're seeing it so exaggerated, and what's gonna stick are the playfulness and the fun that I don't think we've ever seen in fonts just in a long time. And so it'll be fun to see that incorporate into these, because let's face it, branding has gotten kind of minimal and everybody uses one of four fonts, it seems like, for their word mark.
And that's what happens in history.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, as we see a growth of a trend and then a revolt against it. And this is the perfect example, right? We have the blanding that happened a while ago, and this is kind of the antithesis of that. This also, in theory, could be regarded as a Bodonoid, would be the classification. So it's based on a designer, Bodoni, which is probably the font Bodoni. Very thin line weight versus very thick line weight. So I think a lot of what we're seeing is inspired by Bodoni.
It's a good contrast, right, between those two. And everything contrast is the thing that attracts anybody to something visually.
Yep. And it allows you to have that variation and that kind of visual interest to create something new.
Yeah.
So if you want to grab some fonts in this style that are on trend for what we're saying is the new trend of 2023, you can go to Adobe Fonts. And this is just a type foundry. You can go to fonts.adobe.com. This is a type foundry that has really great fonts, especially things like this, right? That are just very wonky, very weird, that hit that trend. And you can go to fonts.adobe.com. And this studio is called Oh No Type Co. So you can search for Oh No Type Co and it will come up. And let's go ahead and just like open one of these And we're just going to type in anchor points. And
look at how you could just test these out immediately. I think one of the coolest tips for any new trend is to just be curious and approach it with a sense of, like, you know, adventure, right? Like, I don't want to ever turn anything down unless you've tried it. Yep. You know,
and this what's cool, so cool, this is a new feature that I've seen, new again, is mm-hmm. you can actually open up Adobe Express templates that use this font. That is so cool. And so it's integrated here. If you want to get into Adobe Express very quickly and you like this font and want to see a template of how you can use it, there are great templates here that you can toss and just start working right in Adobe Express, right? We click, yes. It's going to take us into Adobe Express, open up that template for us, and then we're on our way to creating a graphic based on this template. Okay, that's a really cool feature that, like, literally right now I am discovering is new.
Yeah. What would you say is a huge advantage for a designer to use this either in their job or on a project with a client? What kind of advantage do you think this trend gives them?
I think that for me, I like this trend because it is diverse and, like, open mm-hmm. to a bunch of different styles, right? So we have this style, and even as we scroll through these different templates, you can see that it adapts to high fashion over on the left there. There's some tech. There's some of this, like, music zone. There is vintage looks. It kind of adapts to a lot of things. And because it is so stylistically weird and wonky, I think it's easy to adapt in. And so there are ways to do this custom. And we have a great friend of the show who's going to show us how to do that custom. Our friend Paul Tranny just sent out a tweet that shows how to do this. So go follow at Paul Tranny over on Twitter. And he has a full tutorial here about how to create this effect in Photoshop. Something that I see on this trend as well, Nick, is the color usage is always metallic. Every time I've seen it, it's metallic. Oh,
it's almost like, because it feels melty and it feels almost like molten sometimes a little bit, right?
Yes.
I like that.
Yeah. And so Paul shows you how to create that effect, how to make it this very like chrome look, and then how to render it over in Illustrator. And boom, look at that. It's a really cool, wonky kind of chrome look. So cool. And there's his final. So he combines kind of Illustrator and Photoshop there to create a really cool effect. So
you know what I was going to say is a really cool advantage to this, to anyone who is reluctant or doesn't feel like comfortable enough of doing hand lettering or custom lettering of themselves. There's an individuality on these things that I feel can really stand out when you're showing it to a client, to a boss, or whatever it might be, that is already there. And then maybe even tweak it a little bit yourself too. I think to me, it's kind of like that open door into experimental fonts if you don't feel comfortable doing it by hand.
Yep, absolutely. You know? And so with that, this is the trend that is on the way. That was just a preview of some of the content on Anchor Points.
And if you missed this week's episode, tune in every Wednesday at 1 p.m. Pacific time on twitch.tv/Adobe.
We'll see you there.